Kenny Barron and Barry Harris, from August 1991 at Riverside Park in New York. Now, from the 1992 Riverside Arts Festival, on the 72nd anniversary of Charlie Parker's birth, we have five highly qualified birdmen who rarely work together. Add it up, and there are at least 150 years of bebop experience on this bandstand. Please welcome to Jazz Set Bird's trumpeter from 1949 to 1951, and this afternoon's band leader, Red Rodney. A disciple of Bird and a veteran of Charles Mingus' jazz workshops, Charles McPherson on alto. McPherson's childhood teacher and the keeper of the bebop flame today, Barry Harris at the piano. And the bulldog, or in this case, the bird dog, brother Ray Drummond on the bass, and Thelonious Monk's old drummer, the great Ben Reilly. Thank you.
Yeah. You know, it's wonderful that we're celebrating Charlie Parker's 72nd birthday today, many, many, many years after he's gone. You know, he would have been proud. This is his kind of rhythm section. These gentlemen are very colorful, very tasty, and very swinging, and that's the kind he wanted all the time. So we're very lucky to be playing with these gentlemen, and I'm very thrilled to be here in general. We're going to feature the great Mr. Charles McPherson, and he's going to play one of the ballads that made Bird famous. Is it still Embraceable?
Yeah.
Embraceable You.
Mm-hmm.
Charles McPherson and Barry Harris recorded Embraceable You together 30 years ago for the album Bebop Revisited. Barry remembers an afternoon in the early 50s when he saw Charles for the first time. Charles was walking down Stanford Street in Detroit with his best friend, Lonnie Hilliard. Charles carrying his saxophone case and Lonnie carrying the trumpet. The two became Barry's most dedicated students. It's Bird's birthday, August 29th, 1992, on Jazz Set from National Public Radio. And we have more. Inspired by the album Charlie Parker with Strings, this is Repetition. Thank you. Barry Harris brings out the bebop lovers wherever he goes. But he says that sometimes being around people who don't know he's a musician is the most fun. Lately, if you want to find him, you might try the bowling alley. Specifically, the bowling alley that's upstairs in New York's infamous West Side bus terminal. And it's not just because he's taken up the game. The other reason he hangs there is because, in his own words, the greatest jukebox in New York is now to be found in the bar in the bowling alley of the Port of Authority. Barry's personally stocked it with Sarah Vaughan, Coleman Hawkins, Thelonious Monk, and Lee Morgan's Sidewinder. So now, he says, the bouncer walks around singing Billie Holiday, the bartender's attending Barry's music classes, and strangers are walking up to him saying, "I didn't know you played the piano on Sidewinder."
Friends and disciples and children of God.